Hello, dear students. For the Accounting 1 course, in chapter 2, you'll learn some basics of the recording process. So, you'll describe the characteristics of account and explain accounts as they relate to recording process. You'll define debit credits and normal account balances, record transaction in a journal and post journal entries to the ledger, and you'll prepare trial balance. Therefore, we have four main titles. It's related to accounts, debit credits, and double entry accounting system, steps in recording process, and trial balance. So, this chapter focus on bookkeeping and record keeping procedures. And in this chapter, you'll learn how to record financial transactions and then combine transaction records to prepare financial statements. So it is in a manual system. How can we record any events? Okay. Remember the basic accounting equation. Assets will always equal to the liabilities and owner's equity. And there will be different type of asset items, different type of liabilities and owner's equity. So to follow the changes on each specific asset liability or owner's equity item, we'll need a tool. That tool is account. So an account is an individual accounting tool that shows increases and decreases on each specific item. So we can say that account is a summary device of accounting. In the recording process, accounts are very, very important. And we said for each type of asset, liability, and owner's equity item, we'll need separate, different individual accounts, like cash account, like accounts receivable account, like notes receivable account, like land account. For each type of each specific asset item, you have to use a separate account. And again, for the each type of liabilities, you have to use a separate liability account, like accounts payable, notes payable, salary payable, tax payable. Okay, for each separate liability item, you have to use separate account. And for the owner's equity account, owner's capital, owner's withdrawals, dividends, revenues, and expenses. They are the most common owner's equity accounts. Again, for the manual accounting system, and especially for the teaching purposes, we'll use T accounts. It looks like capital letter T. So, left side of the account will be called as a debit side. Right side of the account will be called as a credit side. They are only named, debit side, credit side. And at the top, we have to mention the title or name of the account. Okay. Only name of the account, like cash, like accounts receivable, will be written at the top. Left side, debit side, right side is credit side. At the beginning, companies must decide which account titles will be used. Therefore, they have to prepare a chart of accounts, they have to prepare the list of the accounts, and after deciding the name of the account, they have to continue use same account titles. So we call them as a chart of accounts. Chart of accounts is a list of account names that a company uses in its general ledger for recording companies' transactions. And accounts are usually listed in the same order in which they appear in companies' financial statements, like balance sheet accounts, income statement accounts, and we can make a list according to this order. And in Turkey, we have uniform chart of accounts. It means all the companies must use same chart of accounts. Title of the accounts are same for each company. And this uniform chart of accounts of Turkey consists of 9 account classes, numbered 1 through 9. For example, 1 is related to current asset, 2 related to non-current asset, 3 related to current liabilities. But don't worry, during this course we'll not use these numbers, but you have to be familiar about the uniform chart of accounts. You have to use that chart of accounts in Turkey. So for each specific balance sheet and income statement item, we'll use separate accounts, but those accounts will be combined on the ledger. So ledger is a record of all the accounts that the company uses, the changes in those accounts and their balances. Ledger is often defined as a book of accounts, one of the main accounting book is general ledger. And we said left side of the account will be called as a debit side. So entering data to the debit side of the account will be called debiting the account. If you are writing any amount to the credit side of the account, we called it as a crediting to the account. So, debit side and credit side of the account will include the data or amounts. If debit amount, total debited amount is higher than total credited amount of that account, account will give debit balance. But if opposite situation is true, it means if total credited amount is higher than total debited amount on that account, we called it that account is giving credit balance. These rules are important. Which side of the account will be used? So as a main rule, you can see the details on the chapter on your book. Assets, owner's withdrawals, dividends and expenses will increase on their debit side and decrease on their credit side. In another words, if asset is increasing, use the debit side of the asset account. If that asset is decreasing, use the credit side of the account. On the screen, for example, you have a cash account. From the transaction one, company's cash was increasing. Remember, owner contributed 50,000 lira to the company. Cash is increasing. Use the debit side of the cash account. On the second transaction, to purchase land, company was using cash. Company's cash was decreasing. Use the credit side of the cash account. So, as you see, company's cash increases on debit side, company's cash decreases on the credit side. Total increases or total debited amount is $55,000 on cash account. Total decreases on cash is 51,000 lira. So this account is giving debit balance as $4,000. $4,000 is equal to the cash amount on hand. Okay. But liabilities, owner's capital and revenues will increase on the credit side of the account, opposite of the asset. And liabilities, owner's capital and revenues will decrease on their debit side. Remember the basic accounting equation. If item is on the left side of the equality, increases are on the left. If items are on the right side of the equality, increases on right side of the accounts. Liabilities and owners' equities are on the right side of the equality. Don't forget this debiting and crediting rules. This is very important. After knowing this debiting and crediting rule, main steps in the recording process must be known. First of all, you have to analyze each event, each transaction for their effects on the accounts. And after, transaction information must be recorded in a journal. Journal is another accounting book. And after completing the journal entry, you have to transfer to the ledger accounts. Okay, those are three main steps of the recording process. Transaction will occur. By looking at the source document, you'll analyze the transaction, and after you'll record in the journal, and recorded journal entry will be transferred to the ledger. We called it as a posting process. Okay, journal, we said one of the very important and main book in the recording process. And original entry or initial entries of the transactions will be made to the journal. Entering transaction data to the journal is known as journalizing. From journal entry to the ledger accounts, data will be transferred. This transferring process will be called as a posting. They are accounting terms. You have to be familiar with those terms. Okay, posting, transferring data from journal entry to the ledger accounts. Okay, again, to remind you, transactions are journalized and posted using five steps. Identify the accounts and account type. Decide whether each account increase or decrease, then apply the debiting and crediting rules, and after complete the records in the journal, and after post to the journal entry to the ledger, and determine whether the accounting equation in balance. In the recording process, we must be very careful because if you make some mistake, results will not be correct. Financial information will not be correct. So decision-making process will be affected. Remember the first transaction in our hypothetical example. Ayşe I starts a new business, and as an owner of company, invests 50,000 lira into the business. So company's cash is increasing. Company's owners' equity is increasing. One event, two different items are affected. Company's cash assets are increasing. Owners' equity as a capital is increasing. You have to use two different accounts. Okay. In the journal, one transaction must be recorded as a one journal entry. As you see, date of the transaction, account titles and explanation, debited and credited amounts will be seen on the blue one. It's a journal entry. After completing the journal entry, you'll transfer to the ledger accounts as a posting process. For each transaction, don't forget in the recording process, when transactions are occurred, you have to analyze the transaction. You have to journalize the transaction in a journal. After completing the journal entry, you'll transfer to the ledger account. And during the periods, you'll do same things in the recording process. But at the end of the period, in order to prove the equality that debits debited amounts are equal to the credited amounts, we have to prepare trial balance. Trial, don't forget, trial balance will be prepared at the end of the period. Trial balance is a list of accounts and their balances at a point in time. That point in time, in generally, ending date of the period. This trial balance proves the mathematical equality of debits and credits after posting. And primary purpose of a trial balance is to prove that debits equal the credits after posting. Trial balance is used to prepare financial statements. Okay, in the chapter 3, we'll learn accrual accounting and adjusting process.